pressure on the ambulance service is so bad, according to a new report out today, that it's actually struggling to cope. Last year, paramedics spent 500,000 hours just waiting to drop off patients because of crowded A&Es, which means an ambulance, while they're waiting, is out of action.
Now, some parts of England are relaxing the current 8-minute target for ambulance to arrive at life-threatening calls. Dr. Hilary is here. It paints a very bleak picture, this, Hills, of the ambulance service. 500,000 hours being wasted, and then at the same time we're being told that they're going to relax the targets as well. Why is that?
They're going to relax the targets because currently what happens if somebody calls the service, a call handler will dispatch an ambulance if it's a serious problem within 60 seconds of that call. But he hasn't had time to assess whether an ambulance is necessary. So they're granting them an extra 4 minutes to really assess the situation. Is it just a chest pain or is it a cardiac arrest? Is it a fit or a seizure or is it an infection or is it somebody who's not breathing?
But so those 3 minutes, though, that sounds like they could be crucial, because if somebody's thinking carefully about making the decision and doesn't just send an ambulance out straight away, time is of the essence.
Absolutely. Currently what happens is more than one ambulance might be sent in order to try and get there within 8 minutes. But that's taking one or two or three ambulances out of service for everybody else. And currently they've got a massive problem. 75%... currently no ambulance trust is able to reach this target of 75% of cases being seen within 8 minutes. So we have to do something because the funding isn't there. Demand has increased by 5%. This is absolutely no fault of the ambulance service. The paramedics do a fantastic job. There's a GP who's often had to call them to somebody's home where I've attended, or someone who's worked in A&E, they do a fabulous job, you know, and they don't get much thanks for it. When they go to casualty to try and offload a patient, if the casualty's full with patients on trolleys because the hospital's full, because there's not enough social care, there's nothing the ambulance service can do.
See, that would seem to be a way of freeing up more ambulance, rather than extending the time to actually get to people, just to make sure that when they get to hospital, they can offload and go on to the next one.
Well, yeah, I mean, it sounds obvious, but...
Is there a way of changing the system a little bit so they don't have to wait to hand over in that way?
It's bed blocking and lack of social... It's easy to admit a patient to hospital. It's very difficult to discharge them to a socially appropriate environment. So if social care is squeezed, so are hospitals, and that would all back... there's back pressure on the ambulance service, and that's what the problem is. So normally they would offload a patient within 15 minutes and then they've got 15 minutes to prepare the ambulance for the next call. But that's not happening. It's taken more than 30 minutes in most cases.
And is that literally because they haven't got time to process and get the notes and put them somewhere safe? And
there's no way to admit the patient to in A&E. So they're already on trolleys in corridors. They're already using inappropriate rooms. And that's one of the problems. But also, there's huge demand from the public in mental health, alcohol problems, elderly with complex conditions. The ambulance service just can't cope. It hasn't had any more funding, and it's attending to 10.7 million calls and transfers every year.
It's an incredible number, isn't it?
One in 10 posts aren't filled because morale is low. They can't recruit. They can't retain. This is a massive problem, and it's just one of the problems facing the NHS right now, to which the government really isn't addressing.